Good morning. We'll wait for 5 more minutes before everybody comes in. Has everybody joined? Should I start?
Divya, ma'am is not there.
Oh, ma'am is not joined yet. Okay, I'll just drop in a message to her.
Yes.
Till ma'am joins in, can anybody tell me what is exactly biomaxillary procedure, or what all do you do in the surgical procedure for biomaxillary surgeries?
We cut both the maxilla and mandible, and we will move according to that the need.
Okay.
In the leaf, in the maxilla, we do the leaf one. And the mandible, we do the BSSO cut.
Okay, understood. Right. So, I think then I'll start sharing my screen. Okay. So is my screen visible to everyone? Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So before I begin, I would want you to know,
yes, ma'am,
what was did you guys try at your end the procedures that we did till yesterday? Do you want me to repeat any part from yesterday before we begin, so that, because see, these are a little complicated steps that you know, going forward again we'll have to do the repositioning for the, you know, we'll take the mandible cuts and then reposition the mandible cast on the bone. But before moving on to that, do you want me to repeat anything from yesterday? Should I then otherwise proceed? I'll continue.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so then I'll continue. Right. So, so I'll just repeat the process till yesterday. What we first did is, let me hide these masks. Okay. First we, like our normal protocol, first we imported our files, our CT scan, right? We selected the CT scan we want to work with, then loaded the CT scan into a new project. Once the project was loaded, what we did is, we created the mask for the bone, right? After creating a mask for the bone, we just isolated the maxilla and mandible into two distinct masks, then calculated the anatomy for the maxilla, right? Once that was done, we then created the planes, which can be seen in the simulation objects. We created the cut planes for the maxilla. Right, the cut planes can be seen here in the 3D tools cut option, plane, polyplane, curve. There are different options. So after getting the correct cut section based on Lafort, we cut the maxilla into two parts, that is
part 1 and part 2. Part 1 and part 2. Once we had our two parts correct achieved, what we did then was we imported using the file and import option. We imported the maxilla cast and repositioned the maxillary cast onto the maxilla bone. If that can be visible here, right? We have repositioned it. Okay. So repositioning is there in align and reposition. We have used three operations for repositioning. One is reposition, the other is point registration, and the third was global registration. We have used these three types of registration to get the exact alignment of the cast onto the bone, right? Now we'll do a similar process for our mandible. And we'll just close all these. Right, I'm just switching on the mandible, right? So here we have our mandible ready. Now what I'll do is I have to cut this. So I will take my first cut here. I'll go to 3D tools, cut with polyplane. Okay. All right. Okay. So keeping this in mind, I take the cut. I'm now just aligning the plane for reference. Right. What you're seeing is I'm adjusting the cut in such a way that it does not pass. See the orange dots? Okay. The orange dots represent the spline. If you see, I've selected this thin structure 2. That is the nerve that we had traced yesterday. Right? So these dots indicate the nerve. So I'm just trying to make my cutting plane in such a way that I don't interfere with the nerve. So So this is our cut. I'll just go to properties and check what's the thickness of my cut. So right now the height is 1. Okay. I'm just going to go. Okay. So first what I'll do is I'll select my objects to cut is will be my mandible. I want to keep original split the result. My cutting plane is the 4th one. I'm going to click OK. Increase the depth to 120. Yeah, now I'll get the cut. Okay. Now I'm going to go again with cut with polyplane. Choose this option. Okay, I'm going to select my object to cut as my maxilla. Yeah. Mandible. My cutting plane will be my CP4 that adjusted. I'm going to do OK. So now we have a mandible cut into 2 pieces that can be seen. Right. Is this clear? Any doubts in this? Do you want to repeat this?
Ma'am, the anterior cut should be between first and second molar.
Okay, first and second. So you want it to be here at this junction. I'll just mark it using this. At that point?
Here.
At that point, should it be the cut?
Ma'am, here, ma'am.
Okay.
More anteriorly. One tooth more.
One tooth more. Understood. I will change the cut then accordingly. Okay.
During the cut.
Understood. Somewhere there, right? I will take my polyester.
बरोबर डिस्काउंट थोडे दिवस अजून नाही आहे थोडं जरा एकदा लॉकडाऊन संपू त्याच्यानंतर मी प्रत्येक याच्यासाठी येणार स्वतः टेम्पो करून पाठवतो. पण इथे अजून नाही ना मला डोअर स्टेप भेटत नाही ना डिलिव्हरी मला प्रत्येक प्रमाणे त्यांच्या गोडाऊन मधून जाऊन अजून थोडे दिवस मग हे पूर्ण झालं नसले की मग रेग्युलर होऊन जातो. मी तर नाही येणार आहे, मी तर ऑफिसला आहे. मी सांगतो मुलाला ते 5 वाजेपर्यंत साडेचार 5 पर्यंत येतो कार्यालय तुम्हाला कॉल.
Is this plane correct now?
Can we use transparency option during this during?
Yes, you can. You can. So
what you can cut so that we can see the nerve and toes.
Yes.
Yes.
You can go to transparency, and the mandible is already under transparent, so you can see your nerve here. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. So the error that had come in this nerve, I've just edited that. Okay. So if we go here, I'm going back to the mandible. I've switched on the mandible. Right. So you can see the nerve. If you want, you can transparent more. There are options here. So I'm just enlarging this. So there is high, opaque, low, medium. So I think medium is okay for us to visualize. You can also take low. So you have two options, like four options for visualization. So now I'll go to polyplane. My object to cut is your mandible. Then I'll go to new only. I think it was somewhere here, right?
So, separate.
Vignesh, apne ko mute kar lo.
Ji.
Ma'am, mera mute hai.
To fir awaaz kahan se aa rahi hai? Koi aur tumhare phone pe kisi us pe?
Then I think this point we'll take. And Is this okay? What I'm going to do is I'm going to just opaque my model, because kya hota hai na, transparency chalu rakhne se project bahut heavy ho jata hai and it becomes difficult to move my object. I'm just going to do that.
विघ्नेश नर्व ट्रेस करना आ गया फिर से रिपीट करना है
नहीं मैम आ गया मैम नर्व तो आ गया
रवि
मैम आ गया
ठीक है
ओके सो ये अभी प्लेन भी हो गया इफ यू सॉ यू कैन एडजस्ट द प्लेन एज यू वांट सो यू जस्ट हैव टू क्लिक ऑन द प्लेन हियर एंड देन वो आपका रेड कलर का जो एरो होता है यू कैन सी दिस रेड एरो दैट इज टू चेंज द एंगल सो वंस आई हवर ओवर दैट रेड एरो मैंने सिलेक्ट दिस आई हवर तो आपको एक ब्लैक कलर का ये दिखता है पॉइंटर दिखता है यूजिंग दैट आई जस्ट चेंज द एंगल For direction, I'll have to use the points. I can just move the points. So I think this is fine. Or yeah, फिर हमको इसको थोड़ा और अंदर shift करना पड़ेगा. Right, so I'm just going to now go to properties, increase the depth to 120. Now I think humko ye wala angle thoda improve karna padega. Okay. Click here. So you can improve the angle just by turning that. Yeah, I think now from behind this cut seems fine. Let me check if aage se kuch change hua hai nahi. So I think overall this cut seems fine now. Is it or do we need any changes? Please let me know.
Looks good.
Looks good, no? Okay, I'll just do that. Okay, so I'll just take the cut. I think ये मुझे और extend करना पड़ेगा क्योंकि ये bone को अभी भी through and through cut नहीं कर रहा है. So I'll go to the properties and I will increase it to 100. Okay, so just increased it exponentially. Maybe this could be at 50-50. Can be 50-50 and then 50. Yeah, this seems fine. Just one second. I think there are a few more people in the joining room. I'll add those. Right. So I'm just going to click OK and use this cutting plane to make my cuts. So my objective cut is my mandible, my cutting plane is CP5, and yeah, I'm gonna click OK. Right. So now can we see the cut highlighted in two different colors? This cut is okay. Yeah. then we'll similarly repeat it for the left side. Right. कॉन्डाइल कट हो गया. आई थिंक वो यहाँ पे आना चाहिए था कट. और ये थोड़ा यहाँ
मैंडिबल फोरामेन के ऊपर रहना चाहिए.
हाँ नहीं, मैंडिबल फोरामेन तो यहाँ पे है. हाँ वो मैंडिबल मैंडिबल फोरामेन के ऊपर ही कटा है, बट आई थिंक कॉन्डाइल कटा है यहाँ पे. तो या I think this will be a better cut. Let me try with this. Let me just delete these parts that we've received. I'll just redo this. Let me go to 3D tools, cut with polyplane. Mandible CP5. Yeah, I think this is the cut that we can go ahead with. I'll just rotate it 360 view. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. So I'll do the same thing for the other side.
Parinita, I need to see how you mark the nerve. I've not seen that.
Oh, okay, ma'am. I will do that. I will repeat it. Sure. No, I'll repeat. That's not a problem. So before moving, then I'll just show you how we mark the nerve only. I'll repeat that. So
you may do that on the other side then.
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, I yesterday only had marked and kept for both the sides so that we could continue today. मैं ये वाला वापस दिखा देती हूँ आपको, ट्रेस कैसे करना है. So the first thing that we do is we shift the contrast to soft tissue because it becomes easier to visualize. I'm just closing these. I'm going to go to the axial view. Try and trace the nerve. So here it is from the mandibular foramen. If I'm pointing it exactly at it, let me zoom in the view, right? I'll first trace it for my understanding through the scan. It's coming here. It's coming here. Right, so going further down. foramen, here it is. I will now again trace it in either the coronal or sagittal view, whatever is convenient. Now again try and see in the sagittal view. It is here somewhere. Here it is. Once you've traced it and understood how your nerve path is, now you can, like, generally view the axial view, because for us that becomes easier to trace. You can use any of the views that you're comfortable with. You can go to segment. There's an option called as trace. And then there's thin structures.